Namaste all of you. My name is Dr. Ritu Singh Rajput, Faculty of Agriculture and Veterinary Science. Today, this is our practical session of Genetic Engineering Lab. Today, I will tell you about the determine the restriction endonucleoside of two restriction enzyme on a circular plasmid and construct a restriction map of the plasmid. Restriction mapping is a process through which one can obtain the complete structural information of the plasmid by using restriction endonuclease. It involves the digestion of DNA with series of restriction enzyme and then performing agarose gel electrophoresis method to separate the digested DNA fragments and measure the molecular size of the same. Principle: negatively charged DNA molecules are separated on the agarose gel matrix according to their molecular weight upon electrophoresis. The position of DNA in agarose gel is visualized by the staining the gel with the low concentration of fluorescent intercalating dye like ethidium bromide. Smaller molecules move faster and migrate further than the larger one because the migration rate of DNA molecules are inversely proportional to the log logarithm of the molecular weight. The method of the frequent perform to determine the size of unknown DNA fragment by comparing with DNA ladders of the known size. A standard curve of the plotting molecular size of the fragment that maker against the reciprocal of respectives. Then we have to count RF value. So now come to the procedure. Procedure is, before starting the experiment, crush ice and place the vials containing plasmid DNA restriction enzyme and SI buffer onto it. In the experiment, plasmid DNA digests into two restriction enzymes, E. coli and HindIII, separately as well as together. Set up the mixture with plasmid DNA, SI buffer, molecular water and E. coli first. Then for the second reaction, for the HindIII digestion, plasmid DNA, 10x buffer, molecular grade water, HindIII third enzyme. For third reaction, ecocyte and HindIII for digestion, plasmid DNA, 10x buffer, molecular biology grade water, and HindIII third and ecori. After preparing the three reactions, you mix the components by gently pipetting and tapping. And then further incubate the tubes at 37 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. After incubation, immediately add 10 ml of 6x gel loading buffer to the each tube. Run the samples on agarose gel. Prepare for the agarose gel electrophoresis. Prepare gel tray, sealing ends with the adhesive tape. Place form in gel tray about 1 inch from the one end to tray position to form vertical such that teeth are about 1 to 2 mm above the surface of the tray. Then you have to prepare 15 ml of 1.0 agarose solution, measure 0.5 gram agarose into a glass beaker or a flask and add 50 ml of 1x TAE buffer. Heat the mixture on the microwave on a hot plate. Swirl the glass beaker flask of generally. After that, you have cool down the solution up to 55 to 60 degrees Celsius. Add 2 ml of EDTA. After that, you have to pour gel tray to depth about 5 mm. Then you have to start run carefully. Remove the tape and from the both end, place the tray in the electrophoresis chamber and fill the chamber with 1x TAE electrophoresis buffer. Load 3 ml of ready to use DNA ladder into well, 15 ml of each DNA sample from the reactions. For reaction 1, 2, well number 1, for reaction 2, for well number 2, and for reaction 3. connect power to the board, electrophoresis at the 100 to 120 volts, and then 19 amp current until the die makers have migrated appropriate distance. Electrophoresis apparatus should always be converted to protect against electric shocks. Monitor the temperature of the buffer periodically during the run. After that, switch off the power supply. Once the tracking die from the wells reaches 3/4 of the gel, which takes approximately 45 minutes, observe the gel on UV transmitter. After that, you can observe the interpretation or result on a gel. So this is all about the how to do isolation of restriction enzyme and how to do reactions of different kinds of restriction sites. Thank you.